I think we should kick off this episode and kick off this new year with the latest perfect phone call to be
so perfect
in by our president. It's probably one of the most perfect phone calls I've ever heard. But it just, you know, like we've been playing recently a lot of the audio clips that have come out of the Trump's attempt to overturn the results of the election and sort of bargain his way out of losing this election. And this latest phone call, which is like an hour of him talking on the phone to lawyers and the Georgia Secretary of State, is pretty special. I mean, like right before we started recording, Chris mentioned that anytime you get to hear Trump talk on a phone call, like just sort of uncensored, like the real uncut dope, it's something special, and it's something that we should celebrate while we still have it, because it won't be around for much longer. So the context of this is that this is a phone call that the Georgia Secretary of State, Trump was just calling him up to just sort of basically harangue him into giving him 11,000 more votes based on all of the, you know,
You got the votes. What are you going to do? Just give me the votes. Just give me the votes.
He sounded like Gil in like a later era Simpsons season, you know, like just, oh, come on now.
Yeah, very sweaty.
Oh, this is bad. This is really bad. You're working, you slave, and you steal just enough for a sweet lick of that shiny brass ring. Don't I get a lick? Doesn't Gil get a lick?
Oh, Gil, you know, old Gil knows you got some votes in those Dominion machines. Sometimes they scan them 3 times. I'll tell you what.
You've heard that, haven't you? You've heard it. Of course you've heard about the scanning. You've heard the scanning.
There's a lot of really choice bits from the phone call, but like it basically is just him reciting as fact everything he's been told over the last month to people who are like, again, I should be stated here, are like Republican state officials and lawyers who have been like appointed by Trump supporting governors to fucking like do their best to humor him. And he keeps saying things like we have all the results are certified. These are certified. And he keeps saying it over and over again. And they just have to keep telling him that that's not true. Or that, like, it just, like, I don't know. Chris, why don't we play the first clip? Let's just get into this.
I don't want to get into it. Because we found a way in other states later. Excuse me. But we don't need it. Because we're only down 11,000 votes.
Yeah, run that back.
But I don't want to get into it. Because we found a way in other states later. Excuse me.
I heard it.
Yep.
Oh, there it is. But first couple times I didn't hear it. It's like a magic eye painting, though. It popped out eventually.
All right. Well,
yeah. He absolutely lets one rip in this
Giuliani style.
You gotta figure that there's like a skid, like a light brown skid.
He's the Barons. Maybe like a Barons going on.
The Barons.
Yeah. Maybe like a just like an oil spill almost.
The oil slick.
Someone's working on their car. Yeah. This is like why he got elected in the first place, though, because he does say, excuse me, like he was coughing. And, you know, people like that.
Yeah, it's manner. Classy.
Yeah. But I have to say, I'm like, I don't know. I know Will said, like, we have to cherish this because it's like the end of this. But like, I don't know. I've just hated this entire storyline so much. Like, at first it was kind of funny when he was like, just like calling people up and being like, can I please win the election? And they're like, no. But
come on.
It reminded me of like why culture was so bad during the last 4 years, because it was just like, yeah, like a fucking idiot impugning, like people are pretty much as bad, if not worse than him, to like do something that they would do normally.
Yeah.
That he just didn't have a plan for. And then people trying to sell a book by like saying that it was the same as the Reichstag fire.
Right.
And just that for like 3 awful months. I'll be really happy when this one's done.
I'll be very happy when the Supreme Court rules to overturn the election and install Trump as God Emperor. It'll be a nice relief to get this stuff off of the headlines.
I'm just like sick of the Trump thing. Like it's 4 years and just like, I don't know. Nothing's gotten better. No one's come up with a novel angle. It's just like different people trying to sell their books called like, you know, fascism with a red, white, and blue stripe.
Mm-hmm.
And, or, you know, people like Lynn Wood also trying to sell something. I don't know. I would take any Biden gaffe over this. I'm so looking forward to that over whatever the fuck this is.
Okay. Well, let's see if we can squeeze just a little bit more juice out of this lemon. I have 2 more clips from the call that I'd like to play. So the next one is sort of the highlight that everyone's been pointing to, because it does seem to point to the most, you know, open evidence of just a felony being committed.
Oh yeah, just wild, just crimes, criming it up. And the beauty of it is, the reason he could do this, people are baffled. How could he do this? Doesn't he know he's being recorded? Is one, he already got acquitted by the Senate for accused bad phone call having, where he just said crimes. And two, many people have now said this, is that a prosecutor would have a very difficult time proving intent behind anything Trump says, publicly or privately, because there's no way that you can convincingly show that he knows what he means when he says things.
If anything, right.
For this to be a crime, you would have to prove that Trump was telling him in his mind, hey, I will punish you with criminal charges if you do not fabricate votes for me. It wouldn't be hard to convince a jury that Trump doesn't think that, that he doesn't understand that, that he saw some very troubling numbers, some very big numbers. These are real numbers. We got them. We see them. We know we have the votes. The votes are there. I've seen them. That he believes that because his brain is fucking cottage cheese. And even if it isn't, even if he's some sort of mastermind, his public persona, he's like Vincent the Chin Gigante. You can't prove that he's compos mentos to fucking be liable for anything.
It's also like, I mean, like, even if he, like, you could argue that he knew what he was saying, it's like, they're just, he's never going to go to prison because then they all have to go to prison.
Yep.
Like, I don't.
No president can go to jail. It's against the rules.
We're not going to see a president go to jail until the very end, because the president's job, you know, as the figurehead and, you know, sometimes custodian of empire, is to do tons of illegal shit.
No one's going to take that job and execute it to the way it needs to be if there's any thought that they might face any accountability for their actions in power. So everyone has to agree that that doesn't happen.
Yeah, Joe Biden, like, had, like, probably explicitly doesn't want to see Trump prosecuted.
100%.
Right, because it's like, no, people need to see that even he gets away with it.
Yes, and because
they need
to see
that we're above you.
And then because you have two parties that are supposed to switch off once in a while, like, that's how it works. People get pissed at the one and then they switch over to the other. They only give that power over willingly because they know that when they're out of power, they're not going to be punished. And as soon as somebody gets punished for something, like, if Democrats prosecute Trump, they know that when Republicans get in, they're going to fucking prosecute them, because everybody could go down, because that's the job, is doing crimes.
Well, I mean, just specifically on the issue of doing crimes and then having your, you know, intent to commit crimes be recorded on a phone call that then gets published in the national press, I would say that this hour-long phone call of him haranguing these people would be, to a jury, pretty good evidence that he believed everything he was saying, so i.e. no felony. Like, he really does think those votes are out there, and he believes
He's seen the votes. His fucking defense in court would just be his lawyers would just bring out the fucking TV shows he was watching. They would just show the episodes of Newsmax that he was watching and tell the jury this is what he was seeing, and he just absorbs it like a sponge.
All right, let's play the next audio clip.
They should share it because you want to get to an honest election. I won this election by hundreds of thousands of votes. There's no way I lost Georgia. There's no way. We won by hundreds of thousands of votes. I'm just going by small numbers. When you add them up, they're many times the 11,000. But I won that state by hundreds of thousands of votes. Now, do you think it's possible that they shredded ballots in Fulton County? Because that's what the rumor is. And also that Dominion took out machines. That Dominion is really moving fast to get rid of their machinery. Do you know anything about that? Because that's illegal.
This is Ryan, Germany. No, Dominion is not moved any machinery out of Fulton County. We're having
have they moved the inner parts of the machines and replaced them with other parts?
No.
You're Ryan?
I'm sure. I'm sure, Mr. President.
And what about the ballots, the shredding of the ballots? Have they been shredding ballots?
No. The only investigation that we have into that, they have not been shredding any ballots. There was an issue in Cobb County where they were doing normal, office shredding, getting rid of old stuff. And we investigated that, but this is stuff from, past elections.
No, I don't know. It doesn't pass the smell test, though, because we hear they're shredding thousands and thousands of ballots. And now what they're saying, oh, we're just cleaning up the office. I don't think that plays.
Mr. President, the problem you have with social media, people can say anything.
No, this isn't social media. This is Trump media. I don't care about social media. I couldn't care less. Social media is big tech. Big tech is on your side, I don't even know why you have a side, because you should want to have an accurate election.
There we go. As long as he says, it's not social media, it's Trump media.
Yeah,
Trump
media.
Good.
By the way, we should have put a warning on that. That's what you just heard was very upsetting. It was basically you were hearing the planning of the Holocaust.
Yeah, that's the WANSEE conference. Yeah, it's brutal.
I couldn't find this on the call, but this is just a quote I have from him talking to one of the guy Brad Raffensperger, the Georgia Secretary of State, and he just says, "They're going around playing you and laughing at you behind your back, Brad. Whether you know it or not, they're laughing at you."
They're not laughing at you, Brad. They're not going to laugh at you.
And what's funny is this, so this comes on the eve of the big, the planned Trump protest in Washington. And then also Ted Cruz and Josh Hawley have each taken up their own ridiculous effort to claim that the results in only the states that would have mattered to the election need to be recertified, or that the electors can be impeached or some bullshit like that. They know it's just for show. I mean, they're just showing out for 2024. But I wonder, had they known that this phone call was going to get leaked the day after they announced all of their efforts? I mean, it is pretty funny for them, because they're just saying that no, this is about, we just need to reinstill confidence in the electoral system because lots of people believe the shit that we tell them. So therefore, we have to, I think one of them, I forget if it's Cruz or Hawley, but they're suggesting some sort of blue ribbon committee where it's just one Democrat and one Republican, or form an independent panel to certify the results of only those specific states. And by the way, only the presidential results, not certify or even look into at all any of the congressional races. Those people are going to be seated, just no problem.
The thing that Cruz is referencing is what they did to resolve the disputed election of 1876, the Hayes-Tilden election, which hinged on disputed electoral votes from a few southern states. And the way it was resolved was Congress created an independent commission with three members, Democrat, Republican, and I believe Associate Justice of the Supreme Court. And over negotiation that ended with the agreement for the Republicans to hold the White House, but in exchange would end federal reconstruction and occupation of the South, they let the third guy say it was Hayes. The thing is that they fucking amended the Constitution after that to make sure that never happened again. That was a breakdown that the system literally did fix. So they're just making something up.
And then I guess the other rub that came out of this is that, a lot of these Republican office holders and pundits are now to deflect away from the call itself. We're saying things like, what kind of a man records a phone call and then leaks it to the press? That is an absolute violation of Roe. If you're having a phone call with the president of the United States where he attempts to suborn felonies from you, and you record that phone call so you can't be blackmailed later, that is female tendencies. That is absolute female tendencies. But I mean, I don't know. It's just these are the last gasps of the Trump administration. He's going out with a phone call, not with a bang, but with a phone call.
He just wanted someone else to take care of it. He just assumed that, because his whole life has been just having incoherent conversations with people who wanted something from him. And it's turning out that since he actually lost the election, and it's not in anyone's real interest to, break the rules, break the structure we have just to keep him in office, they don't need anything from him anymore. So now they're not actually doing it. They're just sort of waving their hand around instead of writing down on the paper. And now he's seeing the result of that. And it'll be very funny to see him, and of course, his followers absorbing the reality of it.
There is definitely a grim comedy to all of these Republican state officials now going on TV and weeping that their wives are getting death threats from unhinged Trump supporters after they've been now been openly identified with this conspiracy to steal the election from him. or it's like, it reminds me of all of the Brexit coverage about the millionaire eel salesman who have now discovered that their eels are dying at Calais, or the guy who needs to export his sex arses. But they're
you got that to bleed sex arses, mate.
It just you could not find a more sympathetic cast of victims here.
Yeah, you remember the guy in Georgia who cried?
Yeah,
because Trump supporters were like bothering his wife. He said it in an interview. Like Aaron Mate sent this to me, where he's like, "I know what election fraud looks like because I work with the Contras." It's like, you know, that's almost like a hack line break joke that you'd see on like, you know, like lefty Twitter. But no, he actually did it. They're all actually all that bad. They all deserve everything that they're doing to each other. I don't give a shit.